His name was Zeno of Elea. And the paradox was about an arrow. All of Zeno's original writings have been lost. But according to a later Greek philosopher, Zeno suggested that we consider an arrow in flight at any instant in time. And at that instant, that now moment, the arrow is frozen in space, motionless. It's neither arriving nor leaving. And if you consider the entire flight, there's an infinity of those motionless, frozen moments in time and space. So Zeno asked, is the flight of the arrow and all motion really just an illusion?
His radical conclusion is that motion is impossible. At a given instant, that arrow is someplace. And then click time forward, it's at some other place, but at no moment was it moving.
But you can see why Zeno's timeless frozen moments are so problematic. We often want to know the speed of something in motion at a particular instant. One solution to the problem of instantaneous speed is a concept called a limit. Let's consider a stick figure who walks half the distance to a wall and does that again and again and again. If the stick figure keeps going half the distance to the wall, they'll get closer and closer, but the steps will get smaller and smaller, and they'll never reach the wall. The wall is an example of a limit. As the number of steps heads to infinity, the distance to the wall decreases towards zero, but the figure will never reach the wall. It helped create a new field of mathematics, calculus.
And that's really the big idea at the heart of calculus, as understood in modern terms, this idea of a limit, that you're supposed to think, how far did I go over a microsecond? That gives me an approximation to my instantaneous velocity, you know, the distance traveled divided by that duration. But that's not yet an instant. So rather than a microsecond, I think now a nanosecond, 1,000 times shorter. How far did I travel then? That gives me a better approximation. And in this limit, as the duration of time goes to zero, you often find you'll get a well-defined limiting answer for the speed. And that limit is what's called the instantaneous velocity.